Ahoy! Today we have huge news regarding upcoming weapons in New World. And this is not data mine information, this is actual in-game stuff. I'm trying to stay away from data mining for now, I don't want to get in trouble for it. So I'm just talking about something that we can actually see in-game. In this case, it's someone else's game. The second part of the Strength vs. Con video is coming tomorrow, by the way. I had to postpone that a little bit because this is obviously super time sensitive. As far as I was able to find out, the first one who found this was NWO Show. Their Twitter handle is @shownwo. The link to their post will be in the description down below, and this is where they posted a screenshot of upcoming weapons. Now, how did they get that and how do we know it's real? Because it is from a sponsored video from Rocket Beans. Rocket Beans creates gaming content in German, and they have a Let's Play channel. And on that Let's Play channel, they uploaded New World gameplay from what seems to be a test server or something of the game, where they seem to have access to characters that have some very maxed out perks in some regards and like a bunch of territory standing and all that. And in this footage from this test server, which I'll also link down below, they apparently received a test version that has features that we don't have yet. And the first part of that you can see here. This is a weapon mastery table, and if you look closely, you'll find a few weapons that don't really exist yet. The first one of those is the Void Gauntlet. Now, seeing the Void Gauntlet here is obviously not very surprising. It was announced at Gamescom more or less through the teasers, and it was already previously data mined. So yeah, seeing that there is just confirming what everyone already figured at this point. But there are two more things here. We have the ranged weapons, and under the ranged weapons, we can see the Blunderbuss. Now, looking at the Blunderbuss, we can see that it actually doesn't have its own icon yet. It uses the icon of the musket, so it wouldn't read as much into that. It could, for example, be that they're testing the Blunderbuss internally, but it may never make it to life. Maybe they might not like how it turns out, because they have to figure out a way to distinguish it from the musket sufficiently, which might not necessarily be that easy. This is further solidified by the weapon description. A ranged weapon that fires high damage cartridges, ideal for keeping targets at a distance and long range combat with high payoff for precise aim, which I'm assuming is a description that may very well just be copied from the musket. What's much more interesting is the little girth that we see at the left side of the screen where the one-handed weapons are. With daggers also having been data mined in the past, it's pretty safe to assume that these are daggers. And what's very noteworthy in that regard is that unlike the other weapons here, the weapon is labeled in a plural. We got sword, rapier, hatchet, and then we got daggers. And the tooltip of the weapon further confirms this. The description is dual wielding one-handed weapons for close ranged melee combat and short ranged throwing attacks. So it seems like that's a very good chance that we'll get our first dual wielding weapon this way. Now, much like the Blunderbuss, this may just be a testing thing and definitely a work in progress, but I feel like there's a relatively high chance that we'll actually see the daggers in game. I think there's a lot of demand for daggers. There's always a specific audience that really, really wants the daggers in a game, and I'm part of that audience, so I would know. Now, I'm not entirely sure if the description is also partially copied from the hatchet here, or if the daggers will actually work similar in that way, that you'll have a melee combat tree and a throwing dagger tree, which would make a lot of sense, but I could also imagine like a poison tree or something like that. So again, take this with a grain of salt. This is clearly from a testing server, but I'm very hopeful that we will see the daggers at least at some point. But wait, there is more. Piskui pointed out that the attribute page actually shows the scaling for the Void Gauntlet. What we can see here is that it will primarily scale with intelligence and it'll secondary scale with focus. We talked about those scalings recently, so it'll have an 0.9 scaling with intelligence likely and then an 0.65 scaling with focus. This makes sense since the Void Gauntlet seems to be partially utility based, so making it scale with focus a little bit to make it a secondary option for supportive players makes a lot of sense in my eyes. But that's not all. If you take a close look at the other stats here, you will notice some things that don't really make sense. You can see the musket icon being displayed primarily in dexterity and secondary in intelligence, as it always has been, but it's also displayed in strength. Since the Blunderbuss currently is displayed with the musket's icon, it seems like the Blunderbuss, at least right now, scales with strength, which would be very interesting for a ranged weapon because that would allow a mix of melee and ranged weapons with a strength build. And not only that, the sword is also listed twice under dexterity. Now we know that the primary scaling of the sword is strength, and the secondary scaling is dexterity, but there's an additional sword displayed as primary scaling dexterity, which makes me think that they're using the sword as a placeholder icon for the daggers, and the daggers will scale with dexterity and with dexterity only. That would be the first melee weapon to scale purely with dexterity and make it a nice combination with the bow. I am super excited and really looking forward to these weapons. If you want to stay updated for more New World news of any kind, as well as tomorrow's video, where I will be talking about the attribute scaling of constitution with the strength and dexterity, then feel free to click the sub button and maybe the bell so you get notified of that. And also, I'd love to hear from you guys which weapon you are most excited for. Are you more of a rogue player and want to use the dagger? And do you want stealth on it or not? Do you want to use the blunderbuss as likely a close range ranged weapon, if that makes sense? Or are you more of a Void Gauntlet user? You want to have that extra utility and all the effects and afflictions that you can apply with it. Again, shoutouts to NWO Show for finding this, and thanks to Piskoi for linking this as well. I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope to see you for the next one soon. Duke Sloth, out.